Hello, I'm Jürgen Bellmann from Sophistic, and I want to show you our pre-stressed slab bridge design.
Usually we have a complete system with a pre-stressed slab, maybe an abutment and piles. But today we want to concentrate only on the pre-stressed slab, and therefore we have a little example, CSM32SlabDesign.dat. It is only a single span bridge, but with non-rectangular supporting lines and with tendons inside. Usually you have an automatic generated mesh, and then the tendons go just through the quad elements wherever they meet them. The construction stage analysis is quite simple. We just have dead load, pre-stress and creep and shrinkage. If we check these results in the animator, please always stop the animation. Choose a constant magnitude of maybe 120, and we see dead load alone, then dead load and pre-stress, creep, additional dead load, and the further creep steps. Then we define and calculate the variable actions, of course the life load and settlement and temperature. The temperature here often gives a double curved slab, but that is what really happens in reality. Now we have all forces of the permanent and variable actions, and we come to the superposition. Therefore, we use a CSM run superpositioning, where we mainly make a Desi max. We only have to define the variable actions, life load, temperature, settlement, and maybe fatigue, and then this routine makes the superpositioning of all. In the first part, only the variable actions are superposed in maxima, and a container is created, maybe on design level. For this, we do not take into account dead load and pre-stress, but only superpose the variable actions, including the psi factors and the gamma factors for the design container. Also, a rare, frequent, and permanent container is created. In a second superposition run, now the construction stage forces GPC are combined with the container forces of the variable actions, and we get the final combination forces for rare, frequent, permanent, and on design level. After the superpositioning, all forces are available for the design. Here we can also use a program design that will prepare the input for the design of the ultimate state, crack, decompression check, and a stress check on SLS. If we run this file, automatic generated BMS inputs will do the design. It is a good idea not to make all checks in one file, but to make first only the ultimate limit design in one run, then in the next task only the crack design, then the decompression check, and then the stress check, because then you can look to the results of every task individually. We first get a numerical output of the shell design program BMS. We can check the punching design. And if we look to the graphics, we also see the element stresses in the first element that we can choose also in the input. We see the tendons, the section is completely under pressure, and as a result we get the necessary reinforcement after the ULS design. The result of the crack design is mainly an increase of reinforcement. In the decompression check, we can get as a result the stresses under the permanent condition here, and we can check if the tendon is inside the compression area. As a result, we also get some wind graph plots, maybe the maximum strain in the direction of the tendon. Of course, this must be negative, 100 millimeter above and below the duct. We can get an area plot, and maybe we get the maximum stress on the top and on the bottom side for this permanent combination. Here we see everything is under compression, so everything is okay. Especially the stress check creates a lot of results. Maybe the nonlinear steel stress under characteristic or rare combination, or the concrete stress under permanent configuration. Which result is created, you can check on the first result of the CSM run. Here you see the design task, nonlinear concrete stress characteristic, reinforcement stress, tendon stress, concrete stress. Here the Eurocode numbers, and on the right side the number of the reinforcement distribution number for wind graph 14-15. In a next chapter you can see how to access to these datas in wind graph. If you look to the legend of this table, you can see that these plots are already prepared for an interactive wind graph. So we just have to go into our Explorer, select this file and open it with wind graph. And then we can interactively change everything, maybe the text height, or the group numbering, or the box settings, so you can prepare your results for your output. Here you can select all available pictures of this stress design. Maybe you have watched the CSM design for beam structures, and as a conclusion we can say that the design for shell elements is much more simple, because we do not need this AQB superpositioning in a shell design. For further information, please look to the CSM manual and the comments in this example, csm.dat/design/csm32/slab/design.dat.
So thanks for listening and goodbye!